Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. How are you all doing? Grade one? Good? That's very great. Yes, I'm also good. Alhamdulillah. Thank you. And welcome to your numeracy class. In today's class, we will be discussing a very, very important topic. That is importance of clock, right? So all of you have heard about the importance of time, that time is very important. We should not waste time. We should be very careful about where and how we are spending time, right? We should set a routine for us. We should be following the timetable and etc., etc. You should be hearing these lines that your mother is saying, that please don't waste time in front of the TV. Please don't waste your time. Go and have some fruitful work, or get yourself involved in something interesting. So all of these things are very, very normal, and we heard these things in our life, right? But what is the importance of clock, or which is the thing which basically makes us, or which tells us about the value of time, is a clock, right? So a clock is a thing which tells us that what time it is, how much time has been passed, how much time we have wasted basically. So that is why importance of clock is very important. Now, if you have observed what I'm wearing on my hand, what is this? It's a watch, right? Okay, so what do it do? Well, this is not possible that wherever we go, we just take our wall clock with us, right? This is not possible. So what do? We have these watches, these hand watches. We can easily have them, and it can help us in basically following our timetable and, yes, doing things at a proper time. So these clocks makes us punctual basically. Okay, so there is this story behind. Okay, first tell me that how many of you wear watches? How many of you have this habit of wearing a watch? Raise your hands. Okay, very few of you. Why? You don't like watches? Well, we have very wonderful watches. You have some cartoon character watches as well. There are some Benton watches on which you click on that. There is this Benton shape watch. You click on that. There is LED light in it as well, right? We have Barbie doll watches. We have Doraemon watches, etc., etc. So you can buy one for you. It's a very good thing. Well, I don't used to be to wear a watch when I was in school. So let me tell you a story for that. Once I was standing at my school gate. It was off time and I was waiting for my bus. And one of my teacher came and she asked me that, can you please tell me the time? And I got very embarrassed. I replied that I don't have a watch. So she said that I cannot imagine a student without a watch. And after that day, I adopted this habit. I started wearing a watch. And this is very, very helpful, especially in your exams, especially when you are going somewhere. So you can have a check and balance on that, how much time you have spent. Let's say when you go to attend your friend's birthday party. Now you cannot spend the whole day in the party, right? Because it's not good, even though it's a weekend, but you should have a proper routine for a weekend as well, that you will be giving this much time to your family. You will be revising your weekly activities or weekly syllabus in this time. You will be visiting your friends or family members. So you should have a check and balance on everything, right? So that is why these watches are very helpful. Well, we have now advanced very good watches as well. We have digital watches as well, and there are some watches in which we can have SIM cards, and we have the tracking watches as well, and etc., etc. So do buy a watch for you, because it's very good and it will help you in becoming punctual. Okay, so the topic that we are discussing is related to this, that what is the importance of clock. So in order to understand the importance of clock, it is important to understand the importance of having a watch as well. Okay, so before moving forward, I'm going to share the screen with you. There is this interesting video related to that, what information a clock gives us. So let's first look at that, and then we will discuss more about it. Okay, so show me a thumbs up if my screen is visible to you or not. Is it? Excellent.
Hello children, have you seen the clock on the wall? In your room and in the house, everywhere. It tells us the time. It shows us three things. hour, minute, and the second. The slimmest needle is for the second. It rotates around the clock 60 times to make up 1 minute. And the longest fat needle is the minute. It rotates another 60 times to make up an hour. And the small fat one is the hourly clock. We have to be efficient, and that's why we always see a small clock.
Okay, so we have discussed this in yesterday class as well, that we have three basically needles, a dial and the three needles. And what do they tell us? The smallest one is the hour needle. Then we have a biggest one, which is the minute needle. And there is this one which keeps on moving, and that is the second needle, right? So it basically, a clock gives us three types of information. That is about the hour, about the minute, and about the second, okay?
Put down on a table in the office and in the school. It's really good to read the clock.
Okay, wonderful. Such an interesting video, right? So it has given you a lot of information that what a clock is and what does it tell us, right? Okay, so let's move forward. I'm going to share the screen with you and we will discuss that. Okay, before sharing the screen, let's discuss what is the importance of clock or where do a clock help us. Let's say the wall clock in your room, how is it helpful for you? Yes, it helps us in getting up early for the school, right? Then it helps us in getting ready for the school so that we don't miss our bus. It helps us in getting ourselves ready if we are supposed to attend an event so that we don't get late. Similarly, it helps us to perform our prayers 5 times a day. It's very important to look, you basically look at the clock and you get an idea that whether it's time, is it time for us a prayer or not, right? So it helps us in prayer times as well. What else? It tells us about the food routine as well, that it's breakfast time, now it's lunch time, now it's dinner time. Okay, what else? It also tells you about it's the play time. See, now let's say if you have this activity, if you have this habit that you go to the playground every day on 5 p.m. So every day you will keep on, you know, looking toward the clock that, okay, when it will be 5 p.m. so that I can go out. So the clock also tells you about that when you can go out. So in general, we can say that a clock basically helps us in setting our whole daily routine. When we are supposed to eat, when we are supposed to perform prayer, when we are supposed to go out, when we are supposed to get up, when we are supposed to have dinner, etc., etc. So a clock tells us about everything, right? Now I want all of you to please open your book, page number 81. This is page number 81. Let's see what is written over here. It says that we need clocks to wake up in the morning to get ready for the school. It tells us when it is snack and play time. It tells us when school is over and we can go home. Like all of you are, you know, keep on looking to the clock in your last period because you want to get, yes, right? Similarly, you keep on looking to the clock when it's your break time, so that when we will get the break, ma'am, can we go for the break? So similarly, the clock is very helpful in all of these times, right? It also tells us when it is time to play in the evening and when to complete our homework. It tells us when it is time for dinner and when it is time to sleep. So like I told you, that in general, we can say that a clock basically sets our whole routine, right? Okay. Now I'm going to share the screen with you and I'll show you different types of clocks and watches. So let's have a look at them. Okay, so let's start with a vintage clock. This is an old traditional one and I love the style of it. Over here, the numbers are written in. Yes, right? So how many of you know how to write this? Wonderful. Okay, these are Roman numbers. Okay, then the next one is, these are all vintage, okay? Then we have a tabletop clock. You might have seen such type of clocks in office tables or in school tables. Then we have a character clock. This is a funny clock. We can place such type of clocks in kids' room, right? Okay, then we have a child clock. This is also very wonderful. See, now like you have the different watches, wrist watches of cartoon characters, you have the wall clocks of cartoon characters as well. Okay, then we have this Chuku clock. This is very famous, that after when you set an alarm or like after every hour, that Chuku came out, right, from the doors. The door gets open and the Chuku came out. So this is also very famous. Then we have the alarm clocks. Well, everybody have an alarm clock in their home. Then we have this digital LCD alarm clock. Like we have discussed about the analog clocks in yesterday class, and like we are discussing it, we will be having a special class, a separate class on digital clocks as well. So now just have a look at it and then we will discuss it in detail, okay? Then we have a pocket watch. Well, a pocket watch is a bit similar to your wrist watch. You can wear it on your wrist as well and you can have it in your pocket as well. And the last but not the least is grandfather clock. It's very big in size and you can put it anywhere. You can hang it as well. So these are a few types of clocks that we have that we use in our daily basis. Okay, now what you are supposed to do, your class activity is that you are supposed to make the picture of one type of clock that you like the most or the clock that you have in your room. Hurry up. So take out your copies, take out your pencils and start drawing. Okay, yes, are you done? Wonderful, show it to me. Excellent work. Okay, okay, if somebody wants to make a watch, you know, a wrist watch, you can make a picture of that as well. Excellent, excellent. Okay, class, that was all for today. What is your home assignment? You are supposed to search for different types of clocks as well. If I missed something, just let me know in tomorrow's class. Hope you guys enjoyed the lecture. I'll be seeing you in the next class. Take care. Allah Hafiz.